Now let's start with another category, condensation polymers or condensation polymerization. Condensation polymerization formed by combination of different monomers with elimination of small molecules. Condensation polymers are basically formed from bifunctional or trifunctional monomers, and also it is known as step growth polymerization. This is because process is carried out at small steps, and therefore it is known as step growth polymerization. Now we will see the first category of condensation polymer, that is polyamide polymer. Polyamide polymers are generally known as nylons, and this nylon is actually the generic name of synthetic linear polyamide, which is obtained by condensation polymerization only. So the important example of polyamide polymer is nylon 66. Numeral 66 is representing the number of carbon atoms are present in bifunctional monomers. This nylon 66 is prepared from adipic acid and hexamethylene diamine. In this case, carboxylic will release hydrogen and it will give to the amines. So there will be formation of nylon salt takes place. Nylon salt, on condensation polymerization under high pressure and temperature, it will lead to the formation of CONH bond. This is known as amide linkage, and also hence it is known as polyamide fiber nylon 66. Now we will see some properties and uses of nylon 66. Nylon 66 is actually a high molecular mass linear polymer. If you talk about the molecular mass of this nylon 66, so it will be 12,000 to 50,000 unit. Nylon 66 passes high tensile strength and also it does not soak in the water. And therefore it is used in making different sheets and also it is used in making bristles for the brush. Nylon 66 is used in manufacturing of surgical sutures and also it is used in making textile fabric. We will see another example of polyamide polymer, that is nylon 6. Numeral 6 is representing number of carbon atoms are present in monomer. Nylon 6 is prepared by hydrolysis of cyclic amide, and the name of this cyclic amide is E-caprolactam. E-caprolactam on heating with water under high temperature, it will undergo ring opening polymerization and NHCO bond will break and it will lead to the formation of nylon 6. Nylon 6 passes high tensile strength and it is very attractive in luster, and therefore it is used in manufacturing of tire cords and a rope, and also it is used in fabric. Having done with first category of condensation polymer, that is polyamide, now the next category will be polyester. Commercially, the most important polyester fiber is sterilin, and which is also called as Tecron. Now let me tell you how to prepare this sterilin. It is made by combination of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid. In this case, alcohol will give hydrogen and carboxylic will give OH. So removal of water molecule takes place by formation of sterilin, and which is also called as Tecron. Sterilin has relatively high melting point and it is a good resistant to chemicals and water, and therefore it is used in manufacturing of wrinkle free fabric by blending it with wool and cotton. So we will get terricot and terry wool. The sterilin we also used in safety helmet. Because of thermoplastic character, this sterilin we used in manufacturing of bottles and packing containers. Now I am going to discuss another interesting but simple topic, which is phenol formaldehyde polymer. Now we need to remember the monomer of this polymer, which are phenol and formaldehyde. Now you can see the monomers are there in the name of polymer itself. These monomers, on combining in presence of acid and base as a catalyst, it will lead to the formation of certain monomers. Now see how these monomers will look. Either this complete CH2O group will come at ortho position, or it will come at ortho as well as para position, or it will come at both ortho and para position. Out of these three, anything we can prepare, only it will depend on what acid and what base we are using as a catalyst. Now we will take in consideration for the first monomer. Can I simply call it hydroxymethyl phenol? Now taking this as a monomer, we have to produce a long and straight chain. This monomer on polymerization in presence of acid and base as a catalyst, we are going to remove hydrogen from left hand side and OH from the right hand side in a form of water. So there will be formation of one polymer takes place, which is called as novalac. Now you can see the units connect with each other with the help of CH2. Now this novellic we used in paints and all. Now we will take extended version of novellic. I have taken more of this novellic and I treated with formaldehyde in presence of acid and base as a catalyst. So this will lead to the formation of extensive cross-linking. And because of this, they become non-reusable. And also they become thermosetting. Thermosetting means what? On heating, they become hard. And this because of extensive cross-linking. And also they become a non-stretchable. And the polymer formation takes place is known as a bakelite. Now let me explain how to draw the structure of this bakelite. So here I used monomer of novellic and I repeat the structure of novellic at the bottom but in the opposite direction. Now you have to connect the paraposition of this novellic with the help of CH2. Now you can see this is structure of bakelite which is easy to remember. Now we will see some properties and uses of bakelite. Because of extensive cross-linking, this bakelite is insoluble and infusible in nature and has high tensile strength. This bakelite is a poor conductor of heat and electricity and therefore it is used in making kitchenware and also it is used to making telephonic instrument. Because of it is bad conductor of electricity, it is used as an electrical insulator. And also this bakelite is a good substitute for a glass. So this is all about how bakelite formation takes place and their uses. Now let us continue with the another polymer which is called as melamine formaldehyde polymer. The monomer of this polymer is melamine and formaldehyde itself. Both these on combining there will be formation of one intermediate takes place which is called as resin intermediate. This intermediate on polymerization OH we are going to remove in the form of water. So there will be formation of cross-link melamine formaldehyde resin takes place. This melamine formaldehyde polymer is a good resistant to heat and moisture and also it is thermosetting plastic and therefore it is used in making decorative table tops and also it is used in making plastic dinner ware. Now we are going to see some examples of synthetic rubber. So the first example is Bunna S rubber. Bunna stands for butadiene and which is also known as 1,3-butadiene. And S stand for the styrene. So these two are the monomer of this Bunna S rubber. Bunna S is also called as styrene butadiene rubber or SBR, which is trade name of this Bunna S. Bunna S is obtained from two different monomer and therefore it is called as copolymer. On polymerization of this two monomer, the double bond get break and it will extended into chain. And where the valency of carbon is less, there we will put the double bond. So after polymerization you will get structure like this and this structure is known as SBR or it is also called as Bunna S rubber. Bunna S is a good substituent for natural rubber and it has good strength and it has good resistance and therefore it is used in tire industry and also it is used in cable insulation. This Bunna S we used in footwear making. Now we will see another example of synthetic polymer is known as neoprene. The monomer of this neoprene is called as chloroprene and also it is called as 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. This monomer on polymerization, double bond get break and extended into chain. So there will be formation of double bond takes place in between other carbon atom. So the structure obtained is called as neoprene and also it is called as polychloroprene. This neoprene we used in making pipes and these pipes we use for transport of gasoline. And also it is used in making oil gasket. This neoprene we used in manufacturing of insulator cable and also it is used in manufacturing of jacket and conveyor belt. Vulcanization of neoprene. Vulcanization of neoprene is carried out in presence of metal oxide rather than sulfur compound. So first let me draw the structure of this neoprene or which is also called as polychloroprene. Now let me draw the another structure of this neoprene. The structure of this neoprene we are going to treat with magnesium oxide. So what exactly will happen in this case? Chlorine will go along with magnesium. So there will be formation of cross-link with oxygen takes place. So this is structure of vulcanization of neoprene which is easy to remember. Now we will see example of semi-synthetic fiber which is known as viscose rayon. And this viscose rayon is obtained from cellulose. And this cellulose is actually a linear polymer of glucose unit with molecular formula C6H10O5. and the modified molecular formula of this cellulose is cell OH, which is used for the formation of this viscose rayon. Now we will see how formation of viscose rayon takes place. This viscose rayon generated from cellulose, and for the formation of this viscose rayon, we are going to take cellulose in the form of wood pulp. So in wood pulp, we are going to treat with NaOH. So there will be formation of alkali cellulose takes place with removal of water. This alkali cellulose on treatment with carbon disulfide, there will be formation of cellulose xanthate takes place. This cellulose xanthate on hydrolysis, there will be formation of viscose rayon takes place. Now we will see some properties and uses of viscose rayon. Viscose rayon is highly absorbent in nature. It means that it is easily soaked in the water, and also it is very soft and comfortable, and therefore we can easily drape well. Viscose rayon easy to dye, and it is versatile in nature. It does not shrink when we heat it, and the most important, this viscose rayon is biodegradable in nature, and therefore it is used in dresses, lining, in the manufacturing of jacket, coat,